Hey guys, welcome to the second episode in the Android development tutorial series. In the last video, we saw how to install Android Studio and how to set up the base project. In this episode, we'll take a short tour in Android Studio and we'll see Emulator and we'll see how to run our first app. Okay, so if you remember in the last app, we left at this place. So now we'll get started. The first thing you need to do is you need to take your Android phones. If you don't have an Android phone, don't worry, you can install something called Emulator. Emulator is just a piece of software which runs on your system, something like this. You know, you can use it like your Android phone. So I'll link to some description notes below on how to install them. It is very easy to install emulators. No, don't worry about it, it's because I'm not showing it here. Okay, so for people, so for people who are using their Android phones, take your phone, take your USB cable and connect your PC and your Android phone. Then what I want you to do, this is only for people who are using their physical devices. For people using their emulators, this is not required. So for people who are using their physical devices, go to settings. Go to about phone in the bottom part. If you scroll down, you'll see an menu called build number. Okay, so just click on it 7 times. You have to tap on it 7 times. So once you tap on it for 7 times, you'll see a toast message. A message something like this, which says, congrats, you're a developer now. I've already done it, that's why I'm getting no need to do it. But since you're doing it for the first time, you'll see a different message there. So once you see that message, I wanted to go back. If you go back, you'll see that about just above the about phone option, you will see something called developer option. This is very important for us. Okay, so go into developer options. If you scroll down slowly, you'll see an option called Android debugging. This Android debugging should be on. So if you read the description there, it says enable the Android debug bridge interface. What is the Android debug bridge interface? It is just an interface which allows us to connect the our Android Studio and the phone so that, you know, you can run the app directly from the studio. Okay, for now that's all we need to know about it. Okay, so once you've enabled the Android debugging, go back and now let's get back to our Android Studio. So if you look at our Android Studio, you might see a lot of options here. It may be really overwhelming. Don't worry about it. Right now I'm not gonna go through each piece and tell you what it does. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go through the state pieces in the Android Studio as we keep learning. So whenever we need to learn something, I'll teach you then, because if I teach you all now, it'll be really overwhelming and you'll forget it. Okay, so I'll teach you whenever you need to know the specific function, so you'll remember it easily. Okay, so if you remember when we were setting up the Android Studio, the base app, you'll remember we created something called a main activity. You might ask, what is an activity? So any screen in an Android app is called an activity, any screen. So suppose, let us assume I have this app called Minimal To Do. So if you go inside this app, sorry for the distortion, there is some problem with my Visor software and that's why this distortion is there. Yeah, now it's fine, see, huh? All right, so if you take this app, any screen is called an activity. So this screen you're seeing right now here, this is an activity. If you click on the plus button, you're seeing a screen right now. This screen is an activity. If you go to settings, you are seeing a screen right now. It is an activity. So if you go to about, you're seeing a screen. So these are 4 activities, okay? So this app has 4 activities. So I hope you understood what activities are. Activities are just screens in an Android application. So for any Android app, you need screens, right? So that's why when we started, we created something called main activity. So when we start our application, that is the activity which is going to be displayed. So what exactly is going to be displayed? Let's go and check. Let's go to Android Studio and check it. So if you go back to Android Studio, click on this project tab in the left corner. Okay, if you click on it, you'll have this app and Gradle folders. Open the app folder and you'll see a folder called manifests. Double click on the manifest folder. So right now, this is called the Android manifest.xml. Whenever your app runs, this is the first field. This is the first layout that's gonna be run on the app. Okay, it comes. Okay, so what I'm gonna think like an Android app. See what happens. Okay, I'm gonna come down. I'm gonna see application. Okay, so this is an Android app. So this label. So the name of our app is my first app. This is the label. Okay, label my first app. These things I'll explain later on as we go on. If you come down, you'll see activity. Android name is dot main activity. So this is the activity that we created when we started the project. Okay, if you come down, if you see this tag called intent filter, you'll see an action and a category. Action is main, category is launcher. So what this basically says is that whenever anyone opens your app, the first thing that's going to launch is the main activity. Okay, so the manifest, the Android comes here, it sees, okay, the user has opened this application, my first app, the user has opened this my first app, and it comes here and sees, okay, main activity is the launcher, so we have to launch main activity, and then it's go, and then it goes to main activity dot java file. Okay, so it goes to main activity dot java file. It is public class main activity. At this point, it doesn't know. At this point, it just knows it's an activity. Okay, when it comes to extends app compact activity, it knows, okay, this is an activity. This you know Java, right? So you know what extend means. So app compact activity is the parent activity. Main activity is the child activity. So it comes, it says, okay, it extends app compact activity. So it gets the properties from app compact activity. It knows, okay, so this is an activity, we have to launch it. It comes down, it comes to onCreate. This onCreate method runs anytime the activity is started. Okay, suppose you have one main activity and you have a settings activity. So you go to settings activity, and when you come back to main activity, it's created again, right? So basically, when you go from main activity to settings activity, the main activity is destroyed, it goes to the settings activity. When you come back from it, it's again created, right? So anytime the activity is created, this onCreate method is executed. Okay, sorry, the next line, don't worry about right now, I'll explain it later. This third line is very important. Set content view r dot layout dot activity main. What does it mean? Okay, so for any activity, there are two components. Okay, one is the XML component and one is the Java component. So you might ask, why do we need two components? Is this an activity, right? So have one file and then do everything. So the thing is, for any activity, right? So since you have one XML component, Java component, if you go to the activity main.xml file, to go to the XML file, go to the left, the projects tab, click on app and go to res. Res is short for resources. Okay, so if you go into res, you have a layout folder. If you click on it, you'll see the activity underscore main.xml. Double click on it, it'll open. So what we basically do is, this activity main.xml is like HTML in websites. So if you know web development, or at least basic front-end web development, you'll know that HTML and CSS is just to position the views. Okay, suppose you have a paragraph tag, suppose in the web page, first you have a navbar, then you have a header, then you have some paragraphs. So in the HTML and CSS, you just make sure it looks however you want to look, right? That's exactly what's happening in this activity underscore main.xml. So whatever we do here, suppose if you click on this text view anywhere, you'll see that this thing is highlighted. Okay, so in this XML file, we just code on how the activity should look. Okay, it's exactly like HTML and CSS together. Okay, so the XML file is for the layout. Then you might be asking, why do we need Java file? That is the same functionality as JavaScript in web development. You need some interactivity, right? When you click a button, something has to happen, or you know, when you swipe, something has to happen. So all that is done in Java. So the XML is for the UI, the user interface, and the Java is for the user interactivity. So suppose you have a this is called a text view. So you have a text view and you have a button. When you click that button, suppose the text has to change. So that is all done in Java. Okay, So in this main activity, what we're saying that for this activity, the UI should be whatever is given in this R dot in this activity main. So what is this R dot layout? So we need a way to, you know, join the activity main.xml and main activity, right? In the case of web development, we have a script tag which combines the HTML and the JavaScript together, right? So the same way, this R is a class which has, suppose you have like 20, 30 XML files, this R class will have a reference to all those XML files. From there, you're taking the layouts, because this is a layout, right? So this is called layout. So from the R class, you're taking the list of layouts. From there, you're taking activity underscore main. So this set content view should be there in every activity and on create. So when this set content view is there, the Android thinks, okay, so this is the XML for the activity and I should display it. And it displays it. Okay, I hope this, until this point, is everything is clear to you guys. If you guys have any doubts at all, comment below and I will reply as soon as I can. Okay, so yeah, we'll run the app, we'll see what happens, and then, you know, we'll end the session for now. In the next session, don't worry, this is the last session with theory. Next session we'll get into coding, we'll make some awesome layouts from next session onwards. Okay, so if you go to the right top, not the corner, in the middle part, you will see a green triangular button. Okay, this is the run button. What this does is, when you click on this button, the app, whatever code you've done it, is installed in the phone in the form of an application so that you can open it and test it. Okay, so let's click on the run button. If you don't see anything here, if you don't see anything in the connected devices, it just means that you don't have a physical phone connected or an emulator open. If you don't have both, just download an emulator, open it, start the emulator, and then come here. Or if you have a phone, connect the phone to the USB, connect the phone and computer with the USB cable, and then come back here. If you have a phone, remember to do the procedure that I told you earlier, because it's very important. If you don't do that, you won't be able to see the option here. So select your phone and then click OK. Once you click OK, the studio will start processing. If you see down, you see a thing called Gradle Build running. So Gradle is just something which converts our code into an application, the .apk. It does all the, it combines everything, you know, into one package, and then installs it in our phone. So let's just wait for the Gradle to run. When you're running it for the first time, it's gonna take a lot of time. Okay, when you're running for the first time, it's gonna take 5-7 minutes depending on your computer speed. Don't worry, the rest of them, it's gonna be pretty fast. Okay, so when you come back to your phone, you'll see my app just opened, my first app. So this is the app we have as of right now. This is the default template in any Android app that you create. But in the next video, we'll create an awesome UI. Okay, and then, you know, we'll learn the basics of Android UI development. Okay, so I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.